Genshin Impact Timeline Edit. It will only evolve 1.0 to 1.6, so there will not be any future spoilers. Unless you're a new player, then why are you watching this? So 1.0 came out in 20th September 2020. So in this time, in pandemic times, it was a very dark era. When it released, there were only two regions, Mondstadt and Yiwei. So that means no Dragon Spine, no Chasm, no Chenyuville. Let's move on to the character banners, which I think everyone is mainly interested about. The first banner had Vendi called Balancing Goblets. And as the first 5 star, and as an Archon, we all thought, you know, as a character banner, he must be strong, right? So, you know, as we do, we pull for him, and is he in the meta currently? I don't really see a lot of Vendi players, so I don't know. You decide. Anyways, the second character banner was Klee. And mind you, a lot of people pulled for Klee. The Klee trailer was very well produced. It's mainly because, you know, the gacha money that, you know, we gave to them. And because of that, you get the infamous 3 video from Tectone where he spent a lot of money on Klee and then regretted it in the end. This is the life of a Genshin Impact player. After the character banners, let's move on to the events. So, you might be thinking, wait, this is the first release, how would there be an event? Well, there was actually 5 events. The first event was Seize the Day, which in my opinion was the best event, because basically it's a login event. And every time you log in, you get Sweet My Dame, Primal Gems for the last, some Character Wit, some Mora. For the second event was Marvelous Merchandise. And basically, I think anyone who has played Genshin should know what Marvelous Merchandise is. And basically, you just have, you get randomized boxes, and each one of them has like gacha loot. The third event is called Barbara's Shining Debut. And basically, not to get this confused with the 1.1 update or the permanent Barbara event, but this was a temporary one. Once you hit AR20, travelers are able to get Barbara for free, you know. For the fourth event was Elemental Crucible, and basically is the first ever co-op event. But the reason why this event, now looking back, seems so crazy was because this event, you had to use 40 resin or just resin just to get the rewards. So it's like, yay, we defeated the monsters, and then wait, I don't have resin, I wasted all that time to get nothing. The fifth event was People's Choice, and basically once you have completed Floor 3, Chamber 3, you're able to get a Xiangling. I think everyone has encountered this event because, well, you know, it's permanent and Floor 3 is not really that hard to get through. You know, it's only the later stages, right? So, yeah, that is it for 1.0. Let's head over to 1.1.